हेलो 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 नाउ एम आई ऑडिबल आई ऑडिबल नाउ
हेलो
सो इन यस्टरडेज लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट थ्री वेरिएबल कॉर्नर ऑफ मैप एंड इन टुडेज लेक्चर वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट फोर वेरिएबल कॉर्नर ऑफ मैप. सॉरी So today we'll be discussing about four variable Cournot map. Yeah. So for example three, we have a truth table where we'll be having a function f of f a comma b comma c comma d. F of x is nothing but the function of the output, and this is the truth table. So we have 16 combinations, that is 0 to 5. So to take this boolean expression from this truth table, we have to consider the ones over here. Ones over here in the f of a, b, c, d. So for this corresponding one, we have to write the expression in the expression that it is a bar b c d. For this, it is a b bar c bar d bar, and for this corresponding one, it is a b bar c bar d, and for this, it is a b bar c d bar. A B bar C D, A B C bar D bar, A B C bar D, A B C D bar, and for this we are not considering as this is the zero. So for that we have written the expression which we have just read out, that is A bar B C D, which is 0 1 1 0 0. Sorry, 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 1 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 1 1 1 0 1 1 0 1 1 1 0. So these are nothing but the considered as max min terms, that is 6 8 9 10 11 12 13 and 14. Did you understand that? How did I? Yes, Vaibhav, any question? Vaibhav, any question?
No, sir, no.
So, are you getting it? How did I write this Boolean expression from the truth table? Is it clear?
Thank you.
Please acknowledge.
Yes, sir.
सेशन सुन रहे हो क्या नहीं आप लोग? Fine. So I hope you guys are not listening. It's okay. We'll see how I can make you listen. So for this midterm, we need to simplify this. The Boolean expression is too long, and the if we draw the circuit for this, so it will become a huge circuit. So in order to simplify this, we use K-map of a 4x4 grid. So 4x4 grid is depicted in the next. Here is the 4x4 grid. So it is A, B, C, D for 0, 0. Wherever there are 1s, we are putting there 1s. Okay. So this is how we have to write 4 variable Karnaugh map. This is A bar, B bar, A bar, B, A, B, and A, B bar. This is C bar, D bar, C bar, D, C, D, C, D bar. So these are the corresponding positions of the cells. This is 0, 1, 2, and 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. Okay. So these are the positions. I'll redraw for your better understanding. I'll redraw it. This is how you have to draw 4x4 Karnaugh map. This is C, D, and this is A, B, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. This is 0, 0. 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. So for ABC, it is 0, 0, 0, 0. So this cell will be 0. This will be 1. This will be 2. This will be 3. This will be 2. This will be 4, 5, this is 7, and this is 6, 8, 9, 11, 10, this is 12, 13, 15, and this is 14. So now I will try to put the ones over here. So what is the expression? Can you, anyone of you, repeat the expression, Boolean expression with min term?
Me?
Yes, can anyone of you repeat it? बुलियन एक्सप्रेशन लिखा है क्या आप लोगों ने? This is the Boolean expression. So it is four eight. We'll just annotate it. I'll put ones wherever these particular numbers are there. Six, I'll put one in cell six. In eight, I'll put one. In 9, I'll put 1. In 10, I'll put 1. And in 11, I'll put 1. In 12, 1. In 13, 1. And in 14, 1. Okay? So these are the two ones. Sorry, how many midterms are there? There are 8 midterms. So I have put 8 ones. 1, 2, 3, 4. And these are the four midterms. So now how can I group these midterms? And remaining I need to take zeros. So the empty cells will be zeros. So consider empty cells as zeros, as there is no output for this particular combination. So the next thing is I need to group them. So the first group is this. Is yellow color visible? This is the first group, and the second group is this. Third group is yes, I'll repeat. Should I draw it once again and tell you? Gaurav?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, in the max term, we have taken it as f of function f is considered as 6. 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, and 14. How did we get this Boolean expression? Do you know? So wherever these cells are there, say for example, we have cell 6 over here, I have put 1. Wherever there is 8, I have put 1. In cell 9, I have put 1. In cell 10, I have put 1. In cell 11, 1. 12, 1. 13, 1. And 14, 1. Now my task is to group them. Are you getting it? How did I put these ones in the four variable Karnaugh map?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Fine. So shall we proceed with grouping? Okay. So this is the first four ones group, and this is the second four ones group, and now how can we group them? So, as far as the previous discussion, we have to group maximum number of ones. So, I can group which is overlaid or overlapped. So this is the third group, and the last group is this. Did you get the grouping? So this has been clearly depicted in the next slide. I'll just show you the slide. So here we have grouped them. Okay. So first group, second group, third group. Okay. Which have already been covered. So for this particular group, for the group red, we have to consider the column first. In column, which term is common?
A.
A is common. Very good. So I will write it A here. And in row, which term is common?
C bar.
C bar. So I have written A, C bar. For this group, there are four rows, so we are not considering four rows. We just consider two columns for a green group. Okay. So for green group, we are considering A, B bar. So we have written this A, B bar. So as I have done this, okay. So they have considered, as this one is already covered, so they have not considered the overlay group. So for this blue group, column, which term is common? Which term is common?
B.
It is B. And for row, C, D bar is common. So it has been converted into B, C, D bar. So this is the simplified version of this particular expression, the Boolean expression which we have discussed. Okay. Did you get this? If you have any doubts, you may ask me. Any doubts?
Sir.
Yes. Your voice is very low. Sir? Can you speak loudly?
Could you please explain the BCD D bar?
BCD bar part. Okay. Not an issue. So for this particular group, we have to consider two columns, right? So in these two columns, which term is common? This and this is common. If that B. is both are one, then it is B. So I have written B here. Okay. For these two, if we consider the row, for both the ones, the row is common, right? So I have written C and D bar. This is C and this is D bar. This is D bar and this is C. Did you get it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Any doubts? Or any other students?
No, sir.
Fine. So take down the examples for your homework. The first expression will be F of A B and C. How many variable Karnaugh map will be used for first expression?
Three.
Very good. So 1, 4, 3, and 7. Simplify this using Karnaugh map, and for second, repeat the same F of. Consider this as second, repeat the same F of 6, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13 and 14. Is it fine? So solve these. The more you practice, the more you will become familiar to these type of expressions. So kindly do practice for this. So tomorrow again we will be discussing about the Quinn-McCluskey methods. So I hope you guys are comfortable with the three variable Kornoff map and four variable Kornoff map. Isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So any doubts regarding the session?
No, sir.
No, fine. Then put your attendance in the chat box. We are left out with only 3 minutes, so kindly make it fast. So the students who have already given their attendance in the chat box may leave the session. सबने अटेंडेंस दे दिया है. इफ यू हैव गिवन अटेंडेंस यू मे लीव द सेशन. Session is going to end. Kindly give the attendance. And then I'll end the session.
Kunjar, Kunjar.